All right, that was pretty cool, dude. The Laurel and Hardy Museum. But
excellent.
You know what? Everybody knows Laurel and Hardy. Nobody knows this guy named Gary that builds cars out of wood, dude. Museum right there at his house, dude.
And he loves this Laurel and Hardy stuff.
And he loves Laurel and Hardy. And he says he incorporates Laurel and Hardy in everything he does.
Yep.
All right, so let's get over to Gary's house and or his museum, he calls it. And I can tell you this, I don't think I'll ever meet anybody else in my life that does this kind of crap, dude.
No.
I think I'm going to park over here and we'll walk up there. What do you think?
I think so, too.
Let's go. Gary, we just got out of Stan and Ollie's museum. What's going on over here at your house, dude?
And here you are at East Boundary at the Ollie Also and Stanley 2 Fine Mess Old Car Museum.
The Ollie Also and Stan 2 Fine Mess Car Museum.
Of Harlem, Georgia.
Of Harlem, Georgia.
And I'm out of breath.
And you're out of breath because at least you're riding a bicycle is something good for you to make you go out of breath.
Yeah, I'm just turning 71.
71
next
years old.
Next week.
You're out riding bikes.
Yeah.
All right, let me ask you a question, bud.
Yeah.
So this is like your own little personal hobby shop slash museum of your own personal use.
It is indeed.
Do you allow people to come over here? And
we do.
Visit?
By appointment.
Well, let's go look at it, dude.
All right. This is my wife. This is my wife, Jean.
Okay.
The boss.
Okay, you weren't supposed to stop talking, Gary.
This is my wife, Jean, the boss.
Okay, thank you. All right, how you doing, Gene?
Good.
And I saw a couple pictures of you. I guess you're in love with Stan Lee and Ollie as well.
Not by choice.
Not just by choice. You just married into it.
Following. Yeah.
Now, do you help Gary out there in the hobby shop building cars, wooden cars?
I help with the seats.
Yeah, the seats?
I help the upholstery seat the seats.
Oh, you're the upholstery girl.
Yes.
Too bad you weren't in Dallas. I got a lot of cars that need upholsterized.
Oh, good.
But you're not there.
No.
You're not there. All right, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go check her out.
I want to welcome you to the Ollie Also and Stanley 2 Fine Mess Old Car Museum of Harlem, Georgia. Ta-da. Roll.
old. Is it Gene, Gary, or George? What the heck here?
Gary and Gene.
Oh, Gary and Gene. Okay.
He's Ollie.
You're Jay and he's G. Got it.
He's Ollie also, and I'm Stanny too.
Oh, there you go. Ollie also and Stanny too. I like that.
You know, in South Dakota, they have presidents on their mountain.
Uh-huh.
We have Laurel and Hardy.
This is
Wow. Well, hold on. But when Gene said on the mountain, she wasn't lying. You literally have them carved. Did you make that?
I did indeed. That's
made out of concrete, dude.
Mount Laurel and Hardy, made out of my son's old white shirts.
Mount Laurel and Hardy, right there. Look, there's the little angel praying for him.
Yeah.
And taking care of him. That's their angel of mercenary that says, you're in heaven, Laurel and Hardy, and we're here to take over and portray you the best we can.
No better words have ever been spoken.
Is that basically how it is?
That's about it.
Okay.
Yeah. Gary made the full-size Laurel and Hardy.
That's life-size size. I mean, that's actual, right down to the last measurement of what they really sizable size they were.
The heads are made out of sawdust and glue, and what was 11 gallons of, what was it? Fiberglass?
15 gallons of fiberglass with a mixture of sawdust.
Wow.
One layer at a time.
Now, you molded these, like, did you do paper mache type creation where you made them out of?
I worked it together with my hands. I started on with some clothes and hardened the clothes, but I couldn't get a way out west garb, so I.
Can I ask you all a question real quick?
Yeah.
Where do you get your imagination to even make this stuff that makes you say, wow, I'm going to do it that way and it's going to work?
From her.
Oh, no. No, I can't imagine.
Hold on, Gene. Are you the creator here and he's just the laborer?
I can't imagine.
Are you actually the real boss? Come on. You are the woman, Gene.
Cannot imagine it until it's done.
Are you giving him the ideas to do this and say, do it with this?
No.
I get some coin from her so I can buy a few things.
Okay. Okay. So do you work on them with him, Jane, or you just watch him?
I help with the seats.
He stays away.
Help mix up the fiberglass?
No.
And
she knows what I have to go through to make things, so she stays away from
me. Okay, let me ask you this, Gary, and then we're going to go inside this creation that you call your world.
Okay.
How long did it take to make these guys right here? From start to finish, what would you say?
I started out with the heads.
Out of sawdust. And Elmer's glue?
Yeah, no, these are made out of sawdust, a mixture of sawdust and fiberglass.
Resin.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then after I made them, I made a mold so I could make other things like the Mount Laurel and Hardy. And
now, is that fiberglass or concrete over there?
That's fiberglass and sawdust.
Oh, that's fiberglass too?
Yeah. And then painted to look like.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work.
You believe that, dude?
Yeah,
if
man.
You go look at that thing over there. I swear to God, it looks like concrete.
I know. It's awesome, man.
These guys are like,
come on, you can show master, more enthusiasm.
These are master artists we're talking to here, all the way in Harlem, South Carolina, Georgia, I'm sorry.
I'm totally in awe, man.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Now, I noticed something else, and then we're going to walk in, I promise.
Okay.
Now I'm going to walk.
Okay.
What's up with the brick down here, Dave? I know there's something is funny about this brick, and you're going to tell us something about it.
These are handmade bricks. Mm-hmm. They make bricks all over the world. These were made in Augusta. And it says Augusta.
I see that.
Each one of them were handmade and fired.
Back when?
Oh, man.
Like 100 years ago?
Back towards the Flintstones, I guess.
Wow. That's crazy. I mean, you guys are really into it, man. You guys are like the Aurora Borealis of Laurel and Hardy. You're like the biggest fans of Laurel and Hardy that ever lived.
Thank you.
Am I right?
Yeah.
I will agree with that.
I never met anybody like this. Dude.
Me neither, man.
This is like going into the Twilight Zone and maybe Back to the Future with Michael J. Fox and not coming back.
Or Saturday Night Live.
Say that again.
Or Saturday Night Live.
Hold on.
Or Saturday Night Live.
With John Travolta?
You haven't seen all of it yet.
Let's go.
Let's
oh, my
go.
God. Let's go check it out.
We can even lock you
in. So here we go into the museum, private collection museum of George and Mary. I'm sorry, that's Gene and Gary in their backyard. And they want us to sign their guest book. And then we go into the magic Willy Wonka world of these two creational people they call Americans. That was in the Vietnam War.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh my God, self-bitch, what the fuck is going on out there? This is Savage Slammer straight out of Miami. Beautiful hat that I got right there. We all know it's a beautiful hat because the situation isn't about my hat. It's never about my head, but we already know that, you fucking cocksucker bastards. What we don't know, though, is that I'm making a vidio while we're here, and it's a special vidio. It's about some special people up there, over there in Georgia country, up in the other side of Atlanta in a little town called Harlem, Georgia. And this guy is like a crazy son of a bitch is what he is. He's all over the place with this Laurel and Hardy that and Laurel and Hardy that, and Ollie also and Stanley too. What the hell? But you know what I found out when I was making this video? It's a very interesting video. It's a video that has to be nurtured and has a lot of informational, situational situations going on in it that says, I don't want to cut and splice. I don't want to take anything out of the video. Basically, the real deal is these people that are in the video are very, very nice people. And I'm going to do minimal splicing, you might say. Splicing and chopping and cutting. And we're going to keep the music down on this one. Because the subject on this is so interesting and so unique that we don't want all the music drowning out the situation. This is 7-Eleven straight out of Miami smoking my cigar. If I could only get a lighter to light it. Not drinking my beer. And I never get my McDonald's fucking hamburger, you cocksucking bastard. I gotta go. Take it easy. See you later. And always remember 7-Eleven's got a beautiful hat too. Are we ready to go?
Yeah.
Go. All right. Hold on. Let me introduce. Okay. We just signed in. Now, they had a little conversation over here, husband and wife conversation, and Gary basically said that Gene is the boss here because he wants her to do all the presentation. And usually when that happens, that means the woman is the boss and actually does wear pants underneath that skirt. All right, Gene. What's going on?
Okay. Well, the first Saturday in October, we have a festival here in town.
Mm-hmm.
And every 2 years, the Laurel and Hardy has a convention, and it was here in 2006.
At your place?
In Harlem.
Oh, okay, okay.
And so there's 250 people came from all over the world. The center row here is from people from all over. And here these guys are from Canton, Ohio.
Okay.
Dennis and Dale, and they're
they
the
almost
ones
look just like them.
They said do. You have to visit Harlem. So 2002, we visited and dressed as the lookalikes. This is us.
Okay.
Me with red hair.
This is basically your life story of coming to Harlem.
Kind of.
Okay.
And so we won.
That's you. That's you right there. Look at that, Larry.
We won the contest, Gary and I.
You sure did. Look at that. I swear to God, that looks just like the guys in the car inside the museum. In 2002, you came to this creation deal, and that's when you both decided, you know what? This is where we're living. This is our home.
He decided.
Yeah.
But you're the boss, Gene. You had to say something.
That was the only thing I got to choose.
And the weather was pretty.
So when you guys were born, did you know that you were going to be like the king and queen of Laurel and Hardy?
I don't think Gene had any idea. I had
no
idea.
Did you know that you were going to marry into some crazy, unusual situation that you are, Gene?
No, I didn't know who Laurel and Hardy were until I was 22 almost when he took
me. Never had a television
because,
show.
Because as far as Gary's concerned, he's been a Laurel and Hardy fan since the day he was born.
Exactly.
Pretty much, yeah.
So what do you think about that, living with the Laurel and Hardy king of kings of the world?
It's been interesting.
It's been interesting.
Tell
us. We were involved in a movie before we moved here called Sweetland.
Right, that's what Gary was saying.
And so we were extras in the movie.
Wow.
This is Ellen Cummings. He drove my Model T Ford.
Uh-huh.
This is me dressed as a grandma.
That's you right there. Wow.
This is Alex Kingston.
Okay. So you guys have actually lived a pretty colorful life ever since you've been together.
Pretty much. Well, 44 years.
44 years.
We did have two kids, too.
And had two kids, and your kids are
Let me ask you a question, Gary. Are your kids sick and tired of Laurel and Hardy and they don't want to hear the name anymore or what?
Nah.
Growing up in it?
They come to love it.
Yeah, yeah.
They won't have nothing
to
do.
They just say that to you so you don't have hurt your feelings, right?
Probably. Yeah.
Okay, let's go, Jane. Okay. You're the boss. Give us a tour, and Gary will be your backup guide.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, here's our movie. That's the movie you made.
Yep. Was the lobby poster with his real car in it.
And that's the real car? Or the
real car.
That's not the wooden one?
No.
Okay.
That's the real car. We'll show you that last.
Okay.
And this is the entrance to our museum. You're too young, but this was the green door. What's that secret you're keeping from the 50s?
Do you remember that, Larry?
Yes, I do.
So this is the green door from some magical moment from the 50s, if you were born and raised in that era.
This was a song. I could
sing it. Oh, it was a song?
I could sing it for you if you'd like.
Okay, can I ask her? Hold on right there. No. All right, Gene, should we let him sing or should we just...
Probably not. No.
You might crack the screen.
It'll take too long.
Okay, let's just go with the green door situation.
I drag it on.
All right, here we go. We're inside the Museum of Cars, and I'm going to be honest with you. I'm just looking around. Let me say this here. I'm looking at these cars, and if I saw these without you telling me, I would not believe that these are made out of wood. What are you thinking, Larry?
That's awesome, man.
I cannot believe this.
Is awesome.
Okay, let's go over the angle here and see what they got.
Okay,
so what we're doing here, we were kind of arguing back and forth about where we should start because there's just so much stuff in this little room to look at. And we're just going to start with this carving right here that is very, very unusual. What kind of frame do they call this? It's a three-dimensional frame, but they have a name for it.
The insert would be make it three-dimensional.
Right. So Gary actually made all this by hand. Let's get with Gary and see what's going on with Laurel and Hardy as they're driving down the gas station back in the 1920s in their 1920 Model A.
Close to Route 66, Riverside, California.
Okay.
And this is a three-dimensional illusion that I made of a 1921 Roadster.
Wow.
And it goes into depth and to show.
You ain't lying. That is some depth, dude.
Things.
And you hand painted all that and everything?
It's only 8 inches deep, but it goes from no scale, which is the clouds, to full scale, which is the leaves and the bark on the trees.
Oh my lord, dude!
And I use all the different mediums to produce this.
It's a light box. They call it a light box.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, let me ask
Shadow
you this:
box
how much time, Gary? How much time are we looking at? Start to finish, what do you think?
A couple years, maybe?
I'd say
2 years. Now, is that every day working on it or off and on?
He has about five projects at the same time.
Wow, that's crazy.
That's why it's hard to keep track of the time. Wow. You know, when you got a lot, when you're...
But it's the love of the hobby that counts, right, Gene?
Yeah, I guess so.
And the love of... Okay,
this is the real car that I restored when I was 19 years old.
That's you.
That's me.
That's you right there.
That's the one.
Do you still have it?
No, I found it 35 years later when we were making the movie Sweetland,
but
that's it right there. And the guy let us take it off and drive it.
So that's the original car right there, 35 years later, the exact same car that somebody restored.
Yeah, awesome. I restored it.
You restored it?
I restored it. Here it is restored right here.
So you restored that car?
I restored it.
And then they used it in the movie?
No, that was the car that's in the other room.
You're getting me confused, bud.
I know, I'm confused.
Okay. All right, so here we are. You got the light box made all the way from zero scale to full scale. And I mean, that's just a beautiful piece right there. I mean, you couldn't even put a price on something like that. I mean, it's just an awesome, awesome situation. But look at this thing down here.
They're hard to find.
One of a kind, of course. Now, look at this thing down here. If you wouldn't have told me that this was wood...
I didn't tell you this was wood.
Oh, this is a metal one.
This is a metal one. This is manufactured.
That's a manufactured one, see?
Manufactured in Kansas City, Kansas. Okay. The Tin Lizzies.
This is a toy that you actually bought.
Yeah, I found it on eBay, actually.
Wow. That's awesome.
It's cars that you see in the
parade. Now, would that be a replica of basically a car that maybe Laurel and Hardy would drive back then?
Model T.
Okay.
Exactly. They called them Tin Lizzies.
Okay. Back to the wooden car era. What's going on? What do we got here?
Okay, this was the first one that I made. Let me drop back here. This was the first thing I made when
Okay, hold on.
Here.
So now we're not going to the first. Okay. Now we're over here. Hang on.
Okay, hold on. So this picture right here was actually the very first thing you ever made out of wood once the building was built.
I made a mistake.
That's not it.
It's this one.
Okay, so it's this one. Okay, let's go back to this one. Here we go right here.
It's one of those bloopers.
It's called a blooper thing, and yeah. All right, 75864, go.
Okay, this was the first thing we made here.
Okay, okay.
When we moved down here to Harlem from Minnesota.
Uh-huh.
This is made out of all different kinds of pieces of cardboard and put together and hardened with fiberglass and shellac and
wow.
You name it. And then,
that thing's awesome, dude.
Sculptures of the guys in
there. Awesome.
It's a three-dimensional illusion.
It's a three-dimensional illusion. It's something that says, wow, I'd like to have that hanging on my wall,
yeah.
Larry.
Yes. And then this is another one that I did after.
And you can't even put a time frame on it, so there's no sense asking how much time. It's just the love and labor of what's going on here. That's awesome, dude.
And then this is the first car that I've made a model car, I should say. It's really a sculpture, a car sculpture.
Uh-huh.
That was produced here in Harlem in 2 years.
And now this one's wood.
This one's all wood, yeah. Except some of the structure in here, support structure.
Right, the metal frame structure. But the body itself and the wheels you made, and are the tires made out of wood, or what is that?
All wood.
What are they?
All wood.
Those tires are wood?
Yeah.
Wow.
And it's a 1902 curved dash Oldsmobile.
Jeez, look at this thing, Larry.
And I helped with the seats.
Okay, now let me ask you this. Does this thing run?
If you push it.
Oh, it's a pusher? What if you had a horse?
If you got it going down,
it steers and the wheels turn if you push it.
But it's amazing. It's unique.
It looks just like it's real one.
It's unique.
And the right size as the real ones were.
What other people do amaze me. So
let me ask you a question, Gary. How do you know when you're building this car, how do you know that that's an exact size replica with not ever even seeing one?
Okay, I know what the size of the wheel is, and I scale everything off of the wheel.
Really?
Like I know this is a 28 inch by 3 inch,
uh-huh.
And so I can take a look at that, and I know what the rest of everything is.
And you just go from there? You start at the frame and the wheels and work your way up?
Exactly.
And all you did is look at pictures?
Pictures, basically. Yeah.
Now, did you help with this one, Jane?
Just the
seats.
You did the seats?
With the seats. And then up above there, those he made when he was a teenager. Those are not kits. Those are just how.
Those are wooden models he made when he was a kid. So you've been doing this all your life.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Wow. This is Laurel and Hardy. This is my engineer and his fireman. And they're gonna work the...
Big number three,
which is the General. The General was a steam locomotive that was stolen from the north, from the south, during the Civil War.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And these are my directions that I created at half scale.
So that's a half scale of the real size of what that is. And you drew those blueprints yourself.
I figured out the measurements. These
now, how would you said you work off the wheels, but how would you figure measurements out from this?
I know.
Now hold on a minute. I'm confused here. That's your drawing, or you found that?
I've altered it.
Okay.
I changed it from full size
measurements. Oh, so you found measurements of it and then half scaled it down. Oh, okay.
Like I know these are 30 inch wheels. I know they're 30 inch wheels because the real wheels are 60 inch.
Okay, I see. You basically did it half the size.
Yeah.
And I can. That's wood.
And the different parts on it, like this is the front of the train. This is the what
the
they
scooper,
call
cattle guard,
call catcher.
Uh huh. Now I see that the mouse on these might possibly move at one time. Were these actually made as puppets?
These were originally. Yeah, these were originally marionettes.
Man, that's
and
a big one.
I made them 30 some years ago, and they never became marionettes. They were started to be marionettes. So what I did was stiffen their joints so I could pose them
the way you want
to be with the General when I found a place to put them.
Wow.
And half scale is size 4 clothes.
Size 4, mm-hmm. Little children.
Mm-hmm. And it'll be this train will be 26 feet long. That'll be from that wall up to the bar. So.
And there's the wheels.
Yep.
Oh, so you're still working on that?
Oh, yeah. Just parts.
Actually, I can't put it together until it's all done.
Really?
This is what they call the flues,
uh-huh.
The original flues. This is half scale again. Takes 130 flues, and I'll be able to open the front of the train to show the flues.
Oh, my gosh.
And this is just an optical illusion because the real one at half scale would be 5.5 feet long. The real flues that are 2 inches in diameter would be 11 feet long.
Oh, my Lord. All right, so what's going on with this? This is, says Studebaker. Is that another wooden model, or is that the real thing?
This is another wooden model.
Oh, my gosh.
Full size.
And that's a full-size, 100% size scale car.
Yep.
And wow.
In here is the...
Now, who is that inside there?
Well, this is my driver. These were usually driven by ladies.
Really?
But this is the dress that my wife wore in Sweetland.
Oh, wow.
It was a post-war 1919 movie.
So you're telling me back in the day when a Studebaker was purchased, women would usually buy these to drive them themselves. It wasn't really a guy's car.
No, right, exactly.
Huh.
And Studebaker started out with wagons. They started out.
Yeah. They were a motor. They were a carriage and then turned into motor carriage.
Exactly.
It's a 1910 Studebaker electric.
And I very often.
It runs out of an electric engine.
Electric, had batteries.
Electric motor, yeah. Electric.
Battery driven. So how would they charge the batteries back then?
They plugged them into the wall, people that had electricity.
In 1910?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah. But everything you see here pretty much, well, for everything you see here, I made.
That is amazing. Is that plexi?
Plexiglass, yeah. I didn't make that.
It's amazing. It's amazing. Now, is this one wood as well?
This one is all wood made out of sawdust and fiberglass. This is a 1919 Model T Ford.
Full scale.
Full scale. And I might add, it's not real. It's
right, it's a wood.
It's sculpture, yeah.
When you say sculpture, that's not wood.
Full size.
Well, it's a wooden sculpture.
Yeah. Now, did you make this out of like wood planks or sawdust and fiberglass? What, when you say wood, what do you...
Several different
formats.
Formats of wood, yeah.
Wow.
Like this is pegboard.
Oh my gosh.
And I've got it all layered, and the tubes are in there, and the tubes are nothing more than dowels. Jeez. And
look at the frame, Larry. Even the frame is wood.
Yeah, the wood. This is all. This is a wooden insert, wooden springs, and I have steel in here.
The only steel is the parts holding that together.
No, the steel. I have steel in here to support.
Oh, okay.
Because I've actually
got. To reinforce the weight.
I've actually got a what they call a. No, I can't think of what this is called.
I-beam?
No, it's what supports the springs.
Yeah, the front I-beam.
Yeah, it's no.
But they got a name for it. Yeah, we understand.
Yeah,
now let's look at that engine because that's pretty unique. I would have never known that was wood. Did you see this engine, Larry?
Yes.
Look at this.
Yes.
That is a wooden engine. If you were walking past it, you would never know that was a wooden engine. I mean, even down to the carburetor linkage itself, is that copper tube wood or is that real copper
down here?
Yeah,
that's real copper.
Okay, so
I made these, of course, that holds the manifold on.
Hours, we're talking hours, Gary. Yeah, we're talking millions of hours here of a hobby that you just love.
7,000 parts.
7,000 parts. I don't even want to add up the hours it would take to do that.
Well,
okay, what about, did Jean make the top for you? I guess she
sewed it together.
She sewed that together.
Yeah.
Wow. Now tell us something about that, Jean. Was that a big job?
It's hard on the shoulders.
Yeah.
Keep it still.
Now, when did Gary do that?
When did he make this? He finished it in 97. So.
97?
Or 96.
So you brought that from Minnesota with you?
Three of them we brought.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Now, when you're hauling something like, let's say, on a trailer, aren't you afraid this thing's going to rattle apart, hauling it around?
No,
Gary?
I take it apart.
You take it apart?
It comes all apart.
They come apart in 7 main pieces.
7 pieces.
7 main ones.
Big lumps of pieces.
Oh, my Lord.
But it all comes apart down to nothing. I'm going to start this up for you.
This one.
Okay, we're going to crank this Model T up so you can see.
You're going to crank it up? Now, this is wood, dude.
This is wood.
How's it going to crank?
I'd crank it like a regular motor, okay. But once it starts, it puts out sawdust for
okay, hold on. Crank it right there a few times. There you go.
Okay. Oh, it's one hit wonder.
A wooden engine crankable car? Now, is that electric or what?
Look at the wooden exhaust coming out. I used to have a horn and lights and everything I could turn on here.
That would come on?
I got my wiring that's
turn that off, Gary.
I made the key too.
That is crazy.
I dropped the key.
You made a wooden key?
Yeah.
Hold on a minute. Did you hear this guy? He made a wooden key, bud.
It's not wooden, but it's brass.
Oh, okay. Metal key. Wow.
Brass.
We got a couple more cars here real quick. Like, this is our another, what is this, a Stormer? Stanley?
Stanley.
This is a Stanley.
Stanley.
This is a steamer.
1911 Stanley.
Is this a steamer car? Would this be a steamer?
Steamer car.
And this is another handmade item. Now, hold on. You got a steam engine in there you built. Steam. Look at this, Larry. Wow.
This is showing the wood here. All the rest of it looks like
it's
this
a boiler
before it's painted.
That's the boiler. It's a Stanley steamer.
And the fire pot's underneath, and the chimney goes all the way to the back, and on the back axle is where the motor is.
This car is made out of bamboo wood. This whole car.
Bamboo.
Bamboo.
Now, when you say bamboo, did you, like, form that in water and bend it? And
kind of. But it's underlaid.
Laminated.
Laminated like plywood, but it's bamboo. They call
thin
it
layers.
Blimpy board, and they use it for underlayment on carpet and houses and stuff. Jeez. To level the floors.
He puts it in the pond out here to loosen it up. And
then he forms it and then lets it dry. He makes his own mold.
Yep.
Now, what do we got over here? This one here is not painted because you can actually literally see this is wood.
I ran out of colors.
Well, someone said make one so you can see the wood. So this is a 1908 Maxwell.
Maxwell. I like that name.
And it's varnished.
And it's varnished.
This particular model was Jack Benny's car.
Was this Jack Benny car? This was the Jack Benny?
Jack Benny car.
Yeah, in the Jack Benny talk shows. Maxwell, the car he never ever got rid of.
Right, exactly.
This is like one part. Like he said, there's seven main pieces. Mm-hmm. This would be one part. So, cardboard and wood.
Oh, my Lord, look at this.
And this is sawdust and glue to make it look like leather. Now I'm out of a job.
Now you're out of a job because he can just make it himself.
Yeah.
Let me show you the motor.
See that.
Let me show you the motor. That's probably interesting.
Oh, my Lord. Look at this, Larry.
That's a two-cylinder opposed.
An opposed two-cylinder. Now, when you say opposed, what does that mean? One cylinder is opposed from the other cylinder?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's what that means. And
is that a carburetor up there, a one-barrel carburetor?
Carburetor, and this is the magneto.
Now, it looks like, did you laminate all this wood together yourself?
Yeah, I did.
That's that right there, that one piece right there is ours. Ours of extensive work. It's ours.
Well, I punch out the parts on a hole with a hole saw.
Uh-huh.
So and it's actually hollow too, because I punched out the center too.
To make it lighter.
Yeah, to make it lighter. Uh-huh. Exactly. Just like these, the same way. Everything that you see on this has been made pretty much like those tires. I run things on the bandsaw or hole saws. Uh-huh. And I can make a hole the size, or not a hole, but a cutout, the size, 5 miles, but then I get tired of walking, so I don't get them.
Wow.
A circle, I'm trying to say.
Okay, so now we got those. Now, what's the ending story over here behind Gene? What's going on?
Well, that's a real buggy.
That's the real metal buggy over
that's
there.
A real buggy.
The seat and the top was disintegrated.
And you restored them.
And we restored it.
Now, hold on, are we or you?
I helped. The seats.
You helped do that.
And the 1970 was our first project.
This was your first project in 1970?
Yeah.
And it was about a 1908,
well, I had
is
a
it?
Bunch of other ones before that.
Now, is this a wooden car?
This is all wood. This is the first car that Henry Ford put into production.
Oh, okay. This is the first. Now, I see this radiator situation going on. I bet those are made out of wood.
Yes, they
this
are.
This is a 1908 or 1903 Maxwell.
A 1903 Ford.
1903 Ford.
Oh, my Lord.
Model A Ford.
Model A Ford.
Gene knows what she's talking about.
The first Model A, but these.
Now, what is this? This is the stamp that pressed all those babies out.
Exactly.
And that's like cardboard wood, or?
No, this is mat board that you find around picture boards. Well, you see it's kind of hard. Well,
you wet it.
I put them in shellac and let them soak in 500 of these for...
And you made one at a time with that little thing that you made.
I stamped them out to emboss them. Like
one at a time.
Mm-hmm. 500 of them.
Yeah.
That's like 500 days.
Desperation.
I mean, how many of those can you make in one day?
Oh, all of them. I'm sure I did. I don't remember.
Jeez.
They were all over the living room, I remember.
What takes...
Living room? Hold on a minute.
What took
a... You're telling me that he does this in his house?
Yeah.
And he's got this big garage?
This was in Minnesota.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah.
But anyways... To make a long story short, I had to lay these, after I soaked them, they were like rubber. And then I laid them out on plastic, or on a piece of
plastic. And waited a couple days.
And
then
let them cure out until they were, you know, they were pliable, they felt like rubber, and then I was able to stamp them out and make them look like, just to finish the effect. to fool the public.
I'll tell you, the detail, the attention to detail is amazing, dude.
A lot of these cars had...
And that's a wooden chain.
A lot of these cars had chain drives.
And that's made out of cardboard.
It's made out of cardboard.
Wooden dowels and cardboard, yeah. and anything that is a wood product related situation.
That's what I try to do.
Jeez, you got more patience than me, you guys. Yeah. And then the very last one, the one that I like because of the name, Buick. I love Buicks. What's going on, Jane? This is like a Buick of what era, what age, and how old is it?
This is the 1907 Buick G. He made them all different colors, all different names. This one he stained.
Uh-huh.
And of course he was looking for something that would have a reflector. There's a cashew can inside.
That's a cashew can.
And covered with wood.
It's a unique situation that says you got to have the imagination to play the game, to find the solutions that says, you know what, Gary's the man when it comes to wooden cars.
Yeah.
Is that right?
That's right.
Am I, and Jean's
I
the wife.
The others, yeah.
That just the wife, yeah.
Just the wife that says, "Hey, I'm here." And finally, the last little replica of a what you call a memorabilia piece made out of wood is right here. It's a very unique piece. It's cute and it's original. What's going on, Gary?
This is a calliope, 1/4 scale calliope. These were very commonly used to head up the parades back in the day. When they, let's see here, I gotta get the music going.
The guys are retired Santa Clauses. We took the suits off. They took the suits off, made new suits, and he made new heads.
This is just barely on right here, but yeah, if it was on even halfway the volume, you wouldn't even hear yourself. But these, I needed some bugles, I don't know if you recognize these, but
I don't.
You see them in weddings.
They're champagne glasses.
Plastic champagne glasses.
Wow.
But let me give you a little. That's what it sounds like when it's going down the parade route.
That's crazy.
That's only halfway.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you, Gary.
That's still only halfway.
Okay,
on.
That's great. That's great, bud. That's a good situation. And this is made out of wood, am I right?
All made out of wood.
And I bet you guys get a lot of ahs and oohs and hand claps and everything else out of this little creation.
We end the parade.
That's crazy. That is crazy, Gary.
All right. This is a very new. I've never seen anything like this. This isn't just a museum. This is like the love of labor. Something that possibly you and me both would not ever have any type of way or shape or form to even try to do anything. Am I right, Larry? This is like impossible situations going on. I never even thought something like this existed. But Gary and Gene, they made it come through. And they're probably the only people that I know in the world that I've ever even heard of that do this stuff. Let's say goodbye to Gene and Gary as we shake their hand. And just another guy and another gal down the road that says, you know what? I can do it. I'm going to do it. And this is what I've done.
All right, thanks a lot, Gary. Shake a hand, make
Thank
a friend
you so
right
much.
There.
Thank you
it's
so
amazing,
much.
Dude. I can't
so
believe
much.
The stuff. I mean, this is crazy. When I said I was going to the Laurel and Hardy Museum, I didn't even think that I would come to this right here. Gene, even though you only do the upholstery, we still know you're the boss, sweetheart.
Thank you.
We still know you're the boss, and it's a great situation.
Goodbye!
We appreciate it. There you go.
Goodbye! All right,
you guys want to get in together with each other? There you
That's
go.
Come on.
That's okay. Go on, Larry. Yeah.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye.
We'll see you later. Take it easy.
Goodbye.
All right.
Goodbye.
All right.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Bye. Bye.
Goodbye.
Everybody say, there you go.
Goodbye.
See you later. All right.
Okay, you know, we were on our way out the door, and Gene says, hey, do you want to see the real car now? The real car. So, you know, let's go ahead and get that with her. We might as well. Let's see what's going on with this thing. It might take a few minutes, but you know what? Just hang in there, and I guarantee you it's an interesting story of what's really going on.
Okay, Jane, go ahead. Final tour guide girl, what's up?
This is a 1915 Last of the Brass.
This is the last year that they made the brass situation was 1915, so this is a rare, rare automobile.
The Last of the Brass, and then 1916, Ford made them all black, so everybody could afford them. They were $350.
Okay.
And this is all original.
This is an all-original steel body car that runs and drives.
Correct.
Was it a four-cylinder job?
Four-cylinder.
Okay.
Automatic. Planetary automatic. So this was in two movies. It was in Sweetland with us.
Mm-hmm.
It was in in Savannah, the SCAD students, S-C-A-D students. It was a...
Documentary?
They were, how should I say it? They were art students, and they never even got a credit for it.
Wow.
And so they were looking for old cars, so it was, this one was a police car in it, so he said, just leave the name on. It was kind of neat.
Oh, this is crazy, man. Now, how long have you guys owned this car?
Since the 70s? 15 years.
Okay, so you purchased it somewhere. Then.
Right before we moved here.
And this is the infamous workshop we're looking at. This is all he uses. This is it.
Yep, this is, he's got wheels on all the, his tools, so then he pulls it out.
But I don't see any tools, Gene. All I see, what's this? I see a table saw, a jigsaw, and a drill press.
There's a... underneath there, and here's all the circles for the train.
But you don't understand, Gene. You would think something to this magnitude, you'd be having a giant 4,000 square foot shop.
No.
This is it. This is the place.
This is it.
Wow, Larry.
20 by 20.
It's amazing, dude.
I know.
20 by 20. He just does one thing at a time.
Oh, yeah.
So.
And I see the barn doors over there. Does that go into your...
That goes into the main room. Double doors.
Yeah. Gosh. Thank you again, Gene. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Is there anything else before I turn the camera? Is that it? It's done.
That's pretty much
a done deal. And it looks like Gary got worn out. He's gone.
He had to go close up the museum.
Well, thank you very much, Gene. Larry, what did you think of that tour?
This is awesome. Totally awesome.
Okay.
I've never seen anything like it.
It put us about 4 hours out of our time, but it was
worth it. That's okay. It's worth this, man. This made the whole trip right here. So.
And you don't like to stop, Larry.
I know.
You don't like to stop.
I know.
See what kind of people you meet.
I know you can be. It's great.
Yeah. Thank you, Jing.
Thank you.
Well, there's nothing else I can say. I mean, the videos that I just made on this tells it all. They'll be archived forever. And for you to enjoy and to look at it and go, what the hell is that? This is Pete, my friend Pete, your friend Pete, traveling the back roads of America and finding and searching out brown signs on the highway that says, check it out. We'll see you later. Take it easy. I got to get down the road. I got to go home because I got some cars to build.
In a barn down.
Oh, really?
Are you serious?
And 4x4 was going to be $9.
Oh, man.
So I said, we'll just cut these down. The windows were $8, so we bought one set and he copied them.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to go behind
amazing,
and
Jay.
See the rooms.
Jeez.
It's not something he bought that was all done.
He made them.
Probably took him as long to make that as one car.
Wow. All right, Gene, that was quite an experience. Let me ask you a question. Can I ask you a question?
Sure, ask me
a question. Don't look at the camera, Gene.
Okay. Where do I look
right
at you?
Here. This is where you're looking, right here.
Okay.
Okay, let me ask you a question, Gene. With Gary not here, what's really going on here? Is he just like insanely crazy with this? And
yeah, he's got lots of projects going, usually five at a time.
Okay, thank you. Is the camera too close?
Pretty much,
then let's go. Let's get out of here.
Makes my eyes cross.
There you go. Thank you very much, Jade.
Thank you.
You guys are wonderful people, believe me.
Wonderful people, Larry.
That is totally right, man.
Let's go. Camera time for you now.
Okay. Oh, man.
One more time, Gene.
Okay.
There you go. Okay. We'll see you later.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. No, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. For
Hold on. What you didn't say the YouTube channel. What is it?
A YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Yeah, he said
a YouTube channel. Isn't it Ollie Also?
Oh, Ollie Also.
Okay. Spell that for everybody.
OlliAlso.
Okay. YouTube channel, Ollie Also. Many, many videos of him actually making stuff in progress and what we just looked at basically here.
Little videos. Okay. Correct.
We'll see you later.
Thank you.
No, thank you. Again. Thank you.
Totally awesome.
Okay. Is there a place to eat around here, Gene?
Sure.
Okay, we're taking you guys to eat.
Oh, well, we probably...
You're going.
Oh, okay.
I already got you on film. See, look. Look. Okay. Let's go. Let's go get something to eat. All right. All right. Do you mind, Larry? What's the problem?
I think it's a great idea.
I think they did us a big favor. Let's buy them something to eat, dude.
Adios, amigos.